Doink, 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 doink.
That was Haley when she was born.
Welcome to my YouTube channel. Subscribe. Hello, everybody. What is going on, everybody? My name is Kirsten. This is take 10 for the intro of this video. This is the Big Booty Boss Academy YouTube, which is fitness, fun. It's pretty much everything, guys. I love to include like vlogs. I also love to include some fitness tips, some workouts, a little bit of everything. Today is a really special today. All right, so today is a really special day because my daughter turns 13, so she is officially a teenager. I have troubles pronouncing English properly, like words, pronunciation, that sort of stuff. It just comes out like how it wants to come out. All right, guys, so this episode is gonna be taking you guys down memory lane. So most of you guys know I was a teen mom. I had my daughter at 16 years old, pregnant at 16, had her at 17. So I'm gonna take you guys through what it was like raising a kid when I was pretty much still a kid myself. But we gotta go over a couple things before we dive into Haley's 13th birthday bash. All right, guys, so one quick thing before we dive into this birthday vlog for my sweet little petunia, Haley, which she hates that name, but I wanna invite any females. Sorry, boys, it is a ladies only fitness community, but I run a free fitness community. It's on Facebook. I drop a live workout every Saturday. We also do meal prep idea Mondays. There's a ton of cool fitness motivation in there. So if you're not already part of the group, the link is gonna be in the description. Click it, join us, answer a few questions, and we can be BFF forever. All right, guys, so Haley, like, what am I trying to say? Like, what the fuck is going on?
It's Haley's birthday today, did you know that?
And that's the end of the episode, I hope you guys. All right, guys, so at 16 years old, I found out that I was pregnant with Haley, and being pregnant and being in high school was quite interesting. I mean, not everybody was walking around with with a baby belly. Quite literally, Haley and I have gone through so much together. Some like really, really high moments, like buying our own place together. And then obviously like some lower points as well, which I feel like is quite normal through parenting. So I had Haley at 17. I took her to grad with me. So I bought Haley a dress for grad. And as we were doing like the little walk, that was like one of the first really cool memories that Haley and I had. Instantly decided to move out of my parents' place. Like, love you, mom, love you, dad. Love you more from afar than from within your house. So Haley and I ended up getting our first condo. I was able to get subsidized, which meant that I was able to just get a little bit of assistance with rent because at the time, I believe I was working at A&W and my condo was like the absolute like pretty much cheapest I could find. And it was about $1,000 a month. And Haley's bedroom was the size of this couch, not even. It was so small. I was really lucky because Haley was such a good baby. Like almost right off the bat, she was sleeping through the night and she didn't whine a lot. And she was just like this cute, cute, cute little squish ball that I like would dress up in really cute clothing, Nikes, all the best for my babe. But she was a really, really good kid. We moved like 8+ times. We moved so many times. We would get into one place. Oh, this is a weird story. I did get kicked out of one place, but I'm actually gonna defend myself on that. I'm a very authentic person, so I keep it real, and like we never threw any parties. Why did we even end up? I honestly don't even know why. The people downstairs didn't like us. So it was me, my sister, and my sister lived with me and Haley for, oh my gosh, from like Haley being 1 all the way to like 8. Me and my sister moved around like to 3 or 4 houses together. I just wanna talk about the like experience of being so young and having a kid when none of my friends were having kids. So for me, it was actually a really cool experience. And I think that a lot of people are like, oh, well, like you can't like travel, you can't do this. And a lot of my friends were going traveling. And to be honest, you guys, they were going traveling and they were getting fucked up in Thailand and Bali and Indonesia. And for me, being someone that really struggled to say no, I actually think that Haley in some sort of way saved my life. And what I mean by that is before I had Haley, I was on a really bad path. I was over drinking. I just wasn't like, I wasn't all there. And I gave into peer pressure at all times. And having Haley at a really young age, like really, really, really forced me to grow up. So one of my favorite, memories with Haley is when we walked her to her first day of kindergarten, I might cry.
She was like wearing these little French braids and Ashley came over and she had her glasses on. And I was like, the teacher left us a note. It was basically like, don't be sad, this and this. And I like dropped Haley off, and Haley, the most responsible kid you'll ever meet, she's like, Mom, you're gonna be okay. And then I was just like, nah, my baby. So I dropped her off at kindergarten. I like cried the entire way home. But Haley has always been very, very independent. And I think it's because when I was, when I had Haley, it wasn't like I was there 24/7. I had to immediately go back to work or I wouldn't have been able to afford a place for us to live. So Haley became very dependent. And sometimes I would get more emotional than Haley. Like there's kids that will like scream and cry and like, Mom, don't leave me. And Haley was like, Mom, I love you. Like, you're gonna be okay. It's gonna be fine. And I was like, it's not. So with all the amazing memories that I've had with Haley, there's a couple times where this kid, oh. So one time Haley and I are taking a nap together. We would always cuddle. We were sleeping and I guess Haley had woken up after me. And I woke up and I felt like someone just like brushed. She's like, hey, Mom, I'm brushing your hair. And I'm like, why are you brushing my hair? She wasn't brushing my hair. She was taking a comb and twisting and twisting and twisting. There was a knot in my hair this big. And like, she's like, Princess Mommy looks pretty. And I'm like, Princess Mommy has to cut a huge fucking chunk of her hair off because you did that. And I remember being so mad. And you guys, quite literally, like she, I don't know what the hell she had done, but this comb was stuck in my head and I had to cut it out. So fond memories, also memories where I just remember being like, okay, I'm not gonna spank my child because I don't believe in that, but did I think about spanking my child? Absolutely. So from a very young age, I think Haley must have been like 6 months when we took her on our first family camping trip. And every single year, you guys, since Haley has been zero, we've gone on a camping trip. Whether it's like been me, my mom, my dad, my brother, my sister, everybody, or it's just me, my mom, my dad, and Haley. That's been like a tradition every single year. And like even up until this day, she gets excited for those camping trips. And I think that's like the really cool thing about Haley is that although through the years, I've noticed that hanging out with mom like isn't as cool, she loves family time. Like we're gonna do an outdoor thing, which you guys will see in this video, and she loves spending time with her family. So I believe, again, horrible with timelines, I believe that we took Haley to Disneyland for her 8th birthday, and the way we did it, you guys, is I went to London Drugs and I got a puzzle made. So I wrapped up this puzzle for her 8th birthday, and the puzzle said, we are going to Disneyland. And she thought we were going to Vancouver to the aquarium, so the next day we hopped on a plane, went to California, and man, that was like one of the most fun trips ever. So nobody really plans on having a kid at 16, but I do believe that everything happens for a reason. I believe Haley was brought into my life for a reason at that time, and watching her grow into this like young lady versus just being a little baby has been super emotional. Like I think I've cried 3 times just because I'm like, I'm a parent to a teenager now, but it's also just been incredible. And it's just cool to see her like what her passions are. Like I'm always like, what are you gonna do with your life? Like, what do you wanna do? And I just know that she's gonna do so many incredible things on this world. This kid, you guys, during the middle of a pandemic, created a business called Confident in Color. She like wrapped up these little packages. She sent them out. She made like 20 sales in her first day. So I just know that she's gonna do something incredible. And I'm just super grateful that she was brought into my life at the time she was, because I know for 150 million zillion percent that the person that I am today would not be that person if I didn't have Haley at such a young age. And you guys, like, I went from partying, drinking, just really like spinning tires in my life and not really making any moves, to having a reason to like try and make myself better. And so since the day Haley was born, up until now, 13 years later, not only has Haley had this like crazy transformation, like I was looking at photos today and I'm like, ah, but I've transformed and grown with her. So it's been a really cool experience and I'm really excited to celebrate her birthday. I got her 2 cakes, ice cream cakes, and I'm just excited to celebrate the little girl that changed my life.
I remember when Haley was like 3 years old and we would go to the park at Glenrose Elementary and spend hours there, me, Haley, and Hobo.
My favorite memory with Haley was when we did like a daddy-daughter day, we went to the mall.
Aww. I love when Haley and I just go and spend the day together. So whether it's like going to the mall or going getting pedicures or going for food, we always have a lot of fun.
One thing I remember was when you decided to send balloons to my mom in heaven.
Aww.
That was the sweetest thing ever.
Is that this year?
That was
it. Yeah, we can do it again this year.